So here's the dealio with regards to that. So FBM versus FBA. All things being equal, Amazon will always give preference to FBA because two important reasons. Reason number one, Amazon makes money from FBA. Therefore, they will do whatever they can, as every business should, to maximize the revenue for their business, okay? So they will prioritize FBA over FBM because of that, because it makes Amazon money. Also, by doing FBA, Amazon is very, very good at logistics. They are world leaders, clearly, at logistics. And so they know if they are handling the logistics, the part where the product goes from the seller to the buyer, they can be assured that the process is good and the process works. Whereas if you are doing it yourself, Amazon does not know if you are doing a good job of getting your products to their customers. Interestingly, that they think of that, to their customers, which is what that seller fulfilled prime I was talking about earlier. Once you get good at doing that, they allow you to call yourself seller fulfilled prime. But to begin with, you're just FBM, fulfilled by merchant. So there's those two things. So all things being equal, FBA always gets the kick. However, with PPC, things are not equal because Amazon PPC, just like all PPC platforms, the number one metric that Amazon uses to work out if your PPC campaigns, pay-per-click campaigns, are being done properly. Let's just bring that up. Let's hopefully there'll be some PPC here. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Of course there isn't, although that's kind of PPC up here. Dun-dun, all up there. Pay-per-click, you only pay when you click on it. So pay-per-click. The number one metric that Amazon uses for PPC to work out if you're doing a good job is something called relevancy. Relevancy, okay? So let's just go to amazon.com.au, which is much more competitive and is one of the many reasons I suggest that you go to amazon.com.au instead of amazon.com. However, so here we are. Notice, top three results are all sponsored results, meaning that's Amazon PPC, okay? So relevancy is the number of searches that are done for soccer ball versus the number of people who click on your advert for your soccer ball. And the higher that number is, that percentage is, the more relevant. That's a pretty down and dirty description, but I think it's a valid description. The more relevant your product ought to be. Because clearly, if somebody's searching for a soccer ball and you show them a basketball, then that's not a relevant search result, and you'll get penalized for that, which is why it's a bad idea to just blindly run PPC on terms hoping to get clicks. You should be laser targeted. Because Amazon rewards you for that. So, with regards to FBA versus FBM for PPC, it's more a question of, Wolfgang, have you set up your PPC properly so that it is hyper-targeted and the results that Amazon is going to show are relevant to the audience that's looking for them? If you do that, then the FBAM versus FBA thing becomes null and void. That supersedes FBA versus FBM for PPC only, for PPC only. For everything else, FBA is the winner. But for this, you know, that supersedes that. Hey, thanks so much for watching that video, and I hope that you got some massive value from it. Before you go, do you live in Australia? If you do, this is for you. Would you like to learn how to sell things on Amazon here in Australia? Would you like to know what sells really, really well and what sells for the maximum amount of profit? Would you like to know where you can source those products from, whether that be in China or here in Australia, and how to source them so you pay bottom dollar and get maximum value for what you're doing? If you do, please subscribe to my channel and like this video, and you'll learn that and much, much more. It's the exact same information that people like Jeff from New South Wales have used to make $45,000 a month on Amazon, that Sue, who's from the sunny coast, has used to purchase herself a brand spankly BMW every single year as a result of her e-commerce business, and the lovely Kate from Barrel in New South Wales has used to make $32,000 a year on, a month on Amazon, and indeed Anthony, who makes $15,000 a month on Amazon selling, as he puts it, odds and sods. If you'd like to learn the exact same information that they use to maximize their profits for their Amazon businesses, subscribe to this video, like my channel, and post below if you want me to teach you something. Okay, I'm out of here. Speak to you soon. Bye. Subscribe. Do it now.